I want to be excited for the live-action Last Airbender, but I'm not. The new Last Airbender show is out, and I haven't watched it, but I'm probably going to watch the first episode at least this weekend, and I'm going to do reviews for each of the episodes. But I'm having trouble being excited for it. I am a huge Avatar The Last Airbender fan. I watched it first when I think I was 16, and I just started getting access to proper TV where I lived. And it was, I don't think it's an exaggeration to say, foundational for me. You know, I'm a fan of lots of things as a creator, where I look at the creation process and the technique, and I am inspired and want to make something like it. But then there's the stuff that's so good you don't even think about it from a technical perspective. You just think about what it means to you personally. And Avatar is kind of one of those things. I guess it's because I watched it at a young age and at an age where you can be strongly influenced. But I thought it was amazingly good back then. I still think it's amazingly good now. Everything about it, you know, the world, the characters, the plots, the emotions, the actions, the results. I don't think it's literally perfect, but it's very, very satisfying in so many different ways. And there's a reason it was a huge phenomenon. It really was this massive success of so many different aspects coming together. And in a way, it was almost impossible to replicate because all the other stuff that's come out of the franchise, even though a lot of it is extremely good, and I would even say some of it is actually equal, we haven't had a product from it that was that perfect throughout. And I don't think a live-action series can come close to that. For one, I think a big problem is just what I'll call optimization. The original Airbender was a show that had lots of magic, had lots of fantasy elements, and so it was optimized and best suited to animation because you can make those things in animation, and it still costs money, but it's like basically everything is possible within animation, whereas there are tons of very real and very basic limits for what you can do in live action, and a lot of them just end up being just create animation, but animation that looks like live action is harder than animation that looks like animation. So I think already by trying to be a live action remake, they're already handicapping themselves by trying to bring something that was best in another medium into the live action medium. And I think we have good reasons for wanting to bring things into the live action medium, where we like to make movies of things like Harry Potter. I think it's not a soulless Hollywood desire to make a product out of everything. I think it's because some things are so good and so powerful and so leaping off the page and so effective that it's like we want to make them live action. We want to spread them to as many people as possible, first of all. And also, I think when these materials and stories are so effective, we want to make them real in a way, as in literally real. We want them to be flesh and blood and physical things in real life in a kind of way, because they feel so real on a certain level. And I think Avatar is good enough that it does evoke that emotion, and has for a long time. I think there are plenty of good reasons to do remakes. You know, it doesn't have to be better than the original. It can just be, you know, a love letter to the original, or it can be a remix, or it can just be, you know, the company making something for the property again because they want to capitalize on the brand, because successful brands have things that people like. I'm gonna watch it, and maybe it'll be really good. Maybe I'll love it. And if it's good and it gets another season and more seasons, I'll keep watching it. I'll watch all of it. But I think we're facing a kind of uphill battle, and I have enough of an idea about how complex projects can be to know that it might not work. So I guess we'll just have to go with the flow and see what happens.